40-yard line. It's smothered by this Panther defensive unit. Let's see if they give him his forward progress. If they really picked up 3 yards, if they don't, he lost about five. They do give him forward progress, and that's going to bring up a 3rd and 13. Early going is very rough for the Gordon Longhorns. 3rd and 13, the incomplete pass on 1st and 15, and there the toss decides for. And he picks up just 2 yards. So the Longhorns go into the spread formation with Costilla at quarterback. Sizemore behind him. There's the pitch back to Sizemore. Now he can run with it or throw. Looking for someone. Has the receiver. Number 20, James Gordon. He catches at the 40-yard line. Now he comes back across the field, and he'll have the first down. He may have fumbled the ball, but in any case, it's going to be recovered by the Longhorns. That's Jake Calder on the receiving end of that pass from Jason Sizemore, and that's the first down for the Longhorns in this ballgame on their initial offensive series. If you're just joining us, just under 7 minutes to go in the first quarter, 12-0 with Harrell, as they scored on their first possession, then recovered an onside kick and scored again. From the spread formation, there's the snap back to Costilla. He has the Sizemore looking for someone. Throws to Costilla. He has it at the 20 down the right sideline. Knocked out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
I love that formation. You have a back to the quarterback, pitch back to the running back, and the quarterback goes out so fast. I just think that it's a great way to run the football team because it throws everybody off. Nobody knows what the heck is going on in the backfield. And you get your best athletes in action every single time.
Well, when you have the athletes that the Gordon Longhorns do in terms of Jim Costilla, Jason Sizemore, Hastings, Tom Arena, Levin, and others, you're able to do that kind of formation. Now from the tight formation, here we go. Costilla pitches back to Sizemore, trying to pick his way up the middle of the field. He does to the 6-yard line. That should be enough for another first down, so it's going to be 1st and goal. Actually, they mark it at the 7-yard line, so 1st and goal for the Longhorns. And listen to this crowd.
Jason Sizemore just 3 yards rushing, has his first rush in the ballgame, a couple yards catching, and going down both of his actions so far throwing the football.
1st and goal as Costilla has it again in the tight formation. Levin in the backfield, he gets the handoff up the middle, into the end zone! John Levin!
Unbelievable, John Levin is such a big kid, a great football player. He powers his way in for a 7-yard touchdown. That's the kind of offense you want in six-man football right there.
Excellent blocking by this Longhorn offensive unit. And you have to believe that the Panthers were expecting Sizemore of Costilla to keep the ball. But it's Levin who goes in for 6 points, and now Sizemore will try to tack on 2 more with the extra point conversion. The snap is down, the kick is up, and you can tell by the crowd that it is good. So with 5 minutes 48 seconds to go in this first quarter, we have a new score from the Mustang Bowl in Sweetwater, Texas. It's Whit Harrell 12 and Gordon 8. We will return in 60 seconds.
Very quick, but I think the difference between these two offenses right now, Gordon, a very nice, conservative offense, driving down the field. Whit Harrell has done it on big plays so far. Probably the biggest play of the football game was an onside kick so far in this game now. And let's see if Whit Harrell can put a good drive together and drive down the field on Gordon. Let's see what Gordon can do on defense.
1st and 15 from the 20-yard line. Have some movement on the line of scrimmage. There's a toss out left. We have a flag, and number 11, Whit Harrell, gets out of one tackle, and now to the 32-yard line. That's Justin Stracer. He was on the passing end of the 25-yard touchdown pass a little bit earlier for Seth Dockery. I think we're going to have some movement either on the Gordon side of the football or maybe some motion against Whit Harrell. Let's see what the officials come up with on this one. Going to be an offside call against Gordon, so obviously Whit Harrell will decline it. And perhaps granted the cadence of the Panther quarterback. In any case, that's at least the third time that I can think of that the Longhorns have been drawn offside. The Cowboys six-man state championship dinner. 2nd and 3 now. There's a handoff up the middle. Breaking out of one tackle and falling forward to the 38-yard line is number 34 for Whit Harrell. That's Justin Sullivan. He will have enough for the first down. They will mark him at the 38-yard
yard line. 5.5 minutes to go in this first quarter in what is already proving to be an exciting ball game in Sweetwater. Spread formation, there's the toss back. Now back across the field to number 15, Jason DeBravani. And he is knocked out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. They may give him the 37, a pickup of just a few. And it's going to bring up second and 10, actually a pickup of about 5 yards. So far, Whit Harrell using a lot of things that are confusing Gordon defensively. Let's see what they do here with the spread formation again. There's the snap back to Lopez. He's looking for someone. Underthrows his intended receiver. Inside the Gordon 30 at the 28-yard line. That was number 21, Seth Dodgery, who was on the receiving end of the touchdown pass earlier. But that time, Lopez just threw that one a little bit short. So the clock is stopped at 5 minutes 15 seconds to go. More importantly, we have got a third and a long hit for Whit Harrell. They seek to convert just inside Gordon's territory at the 37-yard line. There's a snap back to Lopez. He sends it back to Rogers, trying to give Rogers the ball, but he's not going to have it. You can hear the roar of approval there for Chris Chamberlain, number 35, who's on the defending end of that one. And that's actually going to be a loss of about 4 yards. And so Whit Harrell goes into what we would think would be a punting situation if the ball is inside their territory now at their own 39-yard line. Remember, of course, six-man football, the 40 is the infield strike. So the ball is at the 39, and indeed, they are going into a punting formation. No one back to receive the punt for Gordon. There's the kick, end over end, heading towards the left sideline, and it goes well out of bounds. Let's see where they mark it. They're going to mark it at the 25-yard line, so that punt, actually, they're going to mark it at the 27-yard line, so that punt carries 14 yards. And so this Gordon Longhorns defense has risen to the occasion, giving the ball back to their offensive unit in pretty good field position at the 28.
You know, Lynn, one interesting part about these offenses, they work a lot on improvisation. You get the football, look around, there's a lot of waiting, there's a lot of juking going on, and really a lot of things happen just because they happen around the playing that way.
So C11 and size 4 in the backfield. There's a handoff around the right side. 11, he's got some room, breaks down one tackle at the 35 and falls forward to the 38-yard line. Sort of an inside reverse that gets some nice yardage to 11. Looks like they're going to mark him at about the 37-yard line and pick up of about 10. And so Gordon seems to be perhaps getting rid of a few of those jitters. We have one of the ESPN cameramen out on the field right now, and he's motioned to back away from Coach Nelson Campbell as they're trying to focus on the football game. Second and 5, Cosilla in the tight formation has Jesus Arena and Sizemore in the backfield. Pitch back to Sizemore. He has some room, but his ankle tackled at about the 40. He really has some real estate down the right sideline. If he could have gotten past one of the Whit Harrell Panthers, I believe that's number 12, Brandon Rogers, who made a great tackle. Could have been a touchdown saving tackle, because we have seen Sizemore move down the sideline very quickly before.
An incredible athlete to do it all year long for the Gordon Longhorns, you know. And the Gordon Longhorns do have a lot of weapons, 11 size 4 across the field, but I'll tell you what, size 4 is the brightest butter.
Third and a long 3. There's a handoff, 11 up the middle, and he has the first down and more.
Wow. 11. 265 pounds, man. That's a large man.
I think I just heard some moose calls out there.
I tell you, he compares to the moose. In fact, I think he probably outweighs Gerald Johnson by a few pounds.
He does.
But in any case, he picked up the first down there. He's not explosive. He is quick. We may see some of that as the game goes on. But the first down there is the ball that goes to the 34-yard line. There's a push back to Sizemore, trying to find his way around the right side. He's inside the 30 to the 28. And as you say, Gordon methodically moving the football down the field. Not with a lot of flash or a lot of big plays thus far, but they're doing what Coach Nelson Campbell wants them to do. Call it a pickup of about 6 or 7, and it will bring 3 seconds, and let's call it 9.